There are two kinds of fiber. There's soluble and insoluble. Okay? Soluble is like pectins, like what holds jelly together. Insoluble fiber is like cellulose, the stringy stuff in celery. Right? They're not the same. Okay? You need both. Now, real food has both. Almonds have both. Strawberries have both. But you need both. What they're adding to soda, or what they're adding to fiber one bars, or what they're adding to cereal, is soluble fiber, because that's the only thing that is soluble. Otherwise, the stuff would precipitate out, and when you basically get gunk. So you can't add soluble fiber back and expect it to work like the combination of the two together. So what does the combination do? You got a hair catcher on your bathtub drain? Okay, so it's a plastic lattice work with holes in it, right? You take a shower, the hair covers the holes, and you get an impenetrable barrier, and then the water won't go down until you clean it, right? Okay, so the insoluble fiber forms a lattice work on the inside of your duodenum. The soluble fiber plugs the holes in that lattice work, and you form an impenetrable whitish gel. You can actually see it on electron microscopy, coating the inside of your small intestine, which therefore limits the rate of glucose and fructose and some fatty acid absorption from the gut into the bloodstream, thereby keeping your liver from accumulating all the substrate so it doesn't turn into liver fat, keeping your liver healthy. And if you didn't absorb it early, that means it gets moved further down the intestine. And what's in the second part of the intestine that's not in the first part? The microbiome, the bacteria. Well, once it gets to the second part, once it gets to the jejunum, it's a free-for-all. Whether you absorb it or whether the bacteria use it to use it for themselves to metabolize, you know, it's probably equal. So if you consumed it with fiber, it may have passed your lips, but that doesn't mean it passed your intestinal lumen. So just because you ate it, you didn't get it, which is why a calorie is not a calorie, because if you consumed it with fiber, it wasn't for you. It was for your bacteria.